Hello everyone. In this session, we will talk about C pointers. We will try to understand pointers right from the hardware perspective till the basic syntax of the pointers. You must have heard that pointer is a variable that stores address of memory location. But as a beginner, usually the question stuck to the mind is what exactly you mean by the address? What exactly you mean by the memory? Correct? So, we will be spending a little time to understand how exactly the memory is, how exactly the RAM is, how RAM and CPU, they are connected to each other, how they work together, what is basic definition of a pointer, and then how to write a simple syntax of pointer, how to draw the diagram and try to understand the pointers better. So, first, we will talk about what is RAM. Understand that RAM is random access memory. It stores data in memory cells. One memory cell, at the beginner level, you say that it is 1 bit of data. However, whenever the data is stored, the data is stored not as a single bit, but it is stored as a group of bits. It is most common to have 8 bits grouped together to create 1 byte of storage. And that 1 byte of storage makes a memory location. But what exactly that bit is all about? It depends on what type of RAM you have. There are 2 types of RAM, mainly SRAM, static RAM, or DRAM, dynamic RAM. In static RAM, each cell is 1 bit of data is made from 1 flip-flop circuit. While in a dynamic RAM, each cell, 1 bit of data is stored in form of a capacitor. I hope you are aware that flip-flop and capacitor are just electronics terms. We are not really interested in whether it is flip-flop, whether it is capacitor, but we want to understand memory in short at an abstract level so that we understand what do you mean by address. So, as I was telling you, the data is stored as a byte-wise and 1 byte is stored into the 1 location. The diagram beside, you are able to see that there are around 16 memory locations are there. Each location will be identified by some number, and that number is called as addresses. The address will be 0 to n minus 1. As you have seen a diagram, there are 16 locations are there, so the addresses are in a range from 0 to 15. But then how RAM understand which address data to be read or written? No problem. For that, the address is given to the RAM by the CPU. This address is given to the decoder, and then decoder activate the appropriate cell. Then the read and write operation will be done on that. But whether it is read operation, whether it is write operation, that is again given with a special signal that is called as a read or write signal. So once again, the CPU sends address to the RAM. RAM internally have a decoder circuit through which it will activate the appropriate cell, and based on the read or write signal given, the read or write operation will be done on that register. And data will be written or data will be read from that register. Okay, next question is that, but how address is given, how data is written or read? For that, you need to understand how CPU and RAM are connected together. It is very common that your RAM is connected by address bus and data bus. By the way, what is bus? Bus is simply the set of wires. The address bus is set of wires carrying the addresses from CPU to the RAM, while data bus is set of wires carrying the data from CPU to RAM or RAM to CPU. First thing, in a previous diagram, we have seen that the RAM was of 16 locations. If your RAM is of 16 location, we see in the address inputs from A0 to A3, so only 4 lines of address is sufficient. Why it is so? Because a RAM having n locations, it should have m address lines so that 2 raised to m is equal to n. A simple formula that you need to understand. So, taking example, if RAM is of 1024 locations, then it will need 10 lines because 2 raised to 10 is equal to 1024. So, the address will be given from this. Based on that address, the data will be written or read. But how the data is transferred? The data will be transferred with the data bus. But whether write operation to be done or read operation to be done, that is governed by the CPU with the read-write signal. Right? Let us try to elaborate it. Suppose CPU want to write something on a location 1000. What it will do? CPU will first send address 1000 and the write signal onto the address bus and read-write line. And it will also send the data, 8-bit data, to be written to the RAM. RAM on the other side will take the address, will activate that location number 1000, and then whatever data is there, that data will be written on that location. In order to perform the read operation, CPU will send the address, will send a read operation to be done. Based on the address received, RAM will activate the corresponding location and data from that location will be sent back onto the data bus. Right? This is a way your CPU and RAM work together. I hope you understood the importance of address. Without address, RAM will never understand exactly which location the data to be written or data to be read. As you are clear with this, now it's time we can go ahead and formally define the pointer. We say that pointer is a variable that stores address of some memory location. Just now, the address is nothing but a RAM address, which you understand that it is going to be the unsigned number in a range of 0 to n minus 1, right? But the second point important is that it is a variable. Variable meaning by it will have its own memory location. How much size a pointer will need? Obviously, it is nothing but equal to how big address you have. If you are working on a 32-bit platform, obviously, a 32-bit compiler, the pointer size will be 4 bytes. And if you are working on a 64-bit compiler, the size of pointer will be 8 bytes. Right? In C language, the pointer is a special data type. Please note, internally, even though pointer is storing just a number, it is not an unsigned int data type. You cannot convert unsigned int to pointer directly. Do understand that. At the same time, the pointer is a derived data type. Derived data type meaning by it is always on the top of some primitive data type. Like to store the address of integer, you need integer pointer. To store address of character, you need character pointer. To store address of double, you need double pointer. To store address of short, you need short pointer. To store address of float, you might need a float pointer, and so on and so forth. At the same time, do understand that even though character is taking 1 byte, to store an address of character, you still need 4 bytes or 8 bytes, depending on your platform. Even though short is taking 2 bytes, the pointer of short will take 4 bytes or 8 bytes, depending on the platform. So always understand that the pointer variable size will be always the same irrespective of its data. I hope you got the basics of pointer concept. Now it's time to talk about the pointer syntax. And there are two, three important things we need to understand as far as pointer is concerned. The first is declaration of pointer. Second is initialization of a pointer. And third thing is a dereferencing of a pointer. The declaration of a pointer. The pointer is declared as data type star P. But how do I read it? I suggest to read it in understandable manner, read it from right to left. And I will read it as P is pointer to double. I repeat, P is pointer to double. Please read it wisely. P is pointer to double. But just by this declaration, a pointer variable will be created with some garbage address in it. So I want to store some valid address in it. How I can store that? Assuming that D is a double variable, we can simply say P is equal to ampersand D. Again, read it properly. I said that address of D is assigned to P variable. Once you have stored the address, how I can access the value of that double variable via the pointer? That is referred as dereferencing. And it can be done by writing star P. But again, read it better way. I say that it is value at P. So whatever address is stored in P, value at that means value of that variable will be accessed. This ampersand is called as reference operator or direction operator. However, while reading, I suggest you read it as address of operator. At the same time, star is dereference operator or indirection operator. Better you read it as value at. Now, as you get some basic terminologies regarding pointer, it is time that we should take a look at a quick pointer syntax with a small example. Let us see the example one by one. Double A 1.2. What it does? It creates a variable A on a stack having value 1.2. I'm very sure it will have some address. Let's say that, assume that address is 1000. Going ahead, double star P ampersand A. How do we read it? P is a pointer to double and address of A is assigned to that. So again, we say that P is a pointer. So it will have its own location and address of A will be stored into that. Let us continue this on a next level. Read it carefully. PP is pointer to double. I repeat, PP is pointer to double. Just saying that PP is pointer to pointer and it is storing address of P. So PP is a pointer variable. Let's say that it has got its own address. And what you are trying to store inside this? Address of P. So address of P, 2000, that can be stored over here. One very important point to note. Just to keep a diagram simple, I have tried to draw it around figures for the addresses. As you go into the real world, you will realize that you do not have any control over the addresses that you get. And it is very rare that you get the addresses like a round figure. They will be usually contiguous and also depends on the architecture on which you are working. Right? Now, as you have drawn this, let us understand how this diagram helps us to, you know, solve some quick things. But we will not keep us limited to that. We will try to understand in more detail. So, diagram says that what is the address of A? The address of A is just, I can say 1000 as diagram suggests. What is A? Content of A is nothing but 1.2, right? That you see. Next, address of P, as diagram suggests, it is 2000. But what P contains? Oh, P contains the address 1000. And since it is a pointer, I can use value at operator on it. Value at P is simply value at 1000. And what is value at 1000? Yes, I can see that value at 1000 is nothing but 1.2. Going a step ahead, talking about address of PP. So address of PP is 3000. Very good. What PP stores? It stores address of P, which is nothing but 2000. Can I also use value at operator on that PP? Yes, I can say value at PP. Value at PP is just value at 2000. Again, the diagram says that it is 1000. And if you want to access the actual variable, you will find that you need to again say value on that 1000. So I can write it value at PP, that comes out to be 1.2. You must have noted that to access the value of a variable on a pointer, you need a single asterisk, while to access the value of a variable on a pointer to pointer, you need double asterisk. This concept can be quickly considered as level of indirection. So for a normal pointer, level of indirection would be 1. For the pointer to pointer, level of indirection will be 2. I hope this short video has helped you to understand what memory is, how memory and CPU work together, how the concept of pointer is written and read, at the same time, how you can draw the pointer to understand it better. Thank you very much.